The Lord spoke to my heart about missions. I had been singing all my life. As a little girl, 4 years old, my sisters and I were 4, 6, and 8 years old when we began to sing. And we were kept busy in the church singing and conferences and conventions and across the country. But the time came when a restlessness entered my spirit, and I began to seek God to know why. And in process of time, he showed me missions. He showed me the precious little country of Haiti, a country the size of the state of Maryland, with over 7 million people crowded together. Income per capita, $380, where half the children are dead by the time they reach age 5, where so many of them are beggars at 3 years old and 4, where little children, 4-year-olds, go to work every day. Their job is to carry water from the river to the house that would take them in. My heart was broken as I saw conditions in Haiti, and I reached out to them in any way that I could. I came back to the States and began to make known the desperation in Haiti. So many turned a deaf ear, and I said, God, if you just show me what to do, if you will show me how to be a blessing, how to feed these children, I'll go back and do that.
I look and see the gold and the riches, the hoarding mob for selfish gain, the toil of hand. The grain is falling.
I began to ask the Lord what he wanted me to do. It was a miracle. I didn't have money, I didn't have friends, and I didn't have anything to work with, but God provided. From the folks fed from their farms and from their gardens. And it was marvelous how food came in. Fruit and vegetables and meat and whatever we needed came in. We didn't have much meat, but what we had was good. Oh my.
In the hospital, didn't you?
Not in the hospital, no. On the roadside, or wherever she decided to have the baby, the friends who knew what to do would gather around and they'd get a can of water, a can that somebody had used something in the can. And there, she would dip whatever she had in that water and wash the baby and clean the baby up. And I said, I'll take the baby, and the baby's going to be Christian. We're going to teach the baby about Jesus. That's how come I had the school of so many children. I had to travel, yes. And I sang. I'd sing and travel, and God provided. It was amazing how God provides, yes.
Did you travel all over the United States?
All over the United States, New York, Buffalo, all the Northeast, all the Southeast, everywhere I sang.
To raise money?
To raise money. And I put it in mission. Only. Only.
I know.
Sergio, it required a lot of help, a lot of support from the area because the work is great. Mom built very nice buildings, orphanage, a church, a clinic, and a school, and in the surrounding area, many children needed to be educated. The medical need is there, the nutritious need, and things of that nature. Since Mom has now made me the president, I know one thing for sure, that I needed help. And I have found that help in Pastor and Sister Jarman, and also my lovely wife, Dorothy, who Mom loves dearly. The vision never dies. The vision came from God. And as long as we are on this earth, we should carry this vision on. And Pastor Jarman is helping me tremendously to carry this vision.
Precious Father God, we come to you now in behalf of the children and the workers and the people who live and work in Haiti, the people who walk and walk and walk to get to the orphanage, for the people who do the laundry, for the people who do the cooking, and all that must be done all the time. God, I pray your precious hand be upon each one and bring them to a place of total surrender to you and cause them to yield their whole selves, soul, body, and spirit, completely over into your hands, that you can help them to know what way to do and which way to turn and when not to turn at all. And Father, I just pray you touch them now and bless them. Give them the desires of their hearts. Bring to a place of receiving from you, for you have great and wonderful things in store for them, and they have not seen them yet. But bring them to see them, Jesus. I pray in that precious, wonderful name of Jesus. It is done, it is finished, and we have it. And so we rejoice, praise God. Amen and amen, praise God, hallelujah.
Lord did something so wonderful until I just want to share it today. I've been a missionary in Haiti for 37 years. And I have two locations in Haiti. One is Mary Annie, the other one is Jeremy. We dealt with the social welfare department, and they showed me children who were really suffering and needed somebody to care for them and give them a home or do something about the condition they were in. And so I said, I will. They said, lady, don't promise. Now, don't do that because the children are already suffering. Don't promise if you can't do it. I said, I will, but I need God. No, don't bring God in. We don't need you to bring God. I said, honey, I can't do anything without God. He's everything to me. And so I did. I bought the house, a big house, and brought the children in. And then I discovered I had a problem. The problem was, there was no water on that property. Everybody in that area had a bucket, and they hit a mountain footpath.
You're talking about Jeremy, right?
I'm talking about Jeremy, yes. And they hit a mountain footpath, and they would go to where the state provided water out of a big pipe, and they would get water in their buckets and then hit that mountain footpath again and go back home. And I built a little school for the children who weren't going to school. And so, but every once in a while, my boys would get up and grab the bucket and take off for the mountain footpath. And I saw them leaving the class, and they'd have to be out of the class a while and miss part of the test, and all kinds of things were happening to them. And I said, God, this is not right. I know this is not what you want for these boys, to miss part of the test because of having to go get that water like this. I said, I'm going to trust you to do something about this so they can stay in the class under the tree. There was no classroom for them. They were under a tree. I had six trees in the yard, and each tree was where the kids were under for their school day. And so it was hard for them. And so there I was, and I began to pray and read the scripture. And I read St. John chapter 14, verse 14, that says, if you ask anything in my name, I will do it. And I read it over and over again. And I gave God his own word. And I said to him, God, you said, if we asked anything in your name, you would do it. And I kept on doing that and kept repeating it until it was like a bell in my heart and in my mind. And so then I said, okay, I'm going to look for someone now, and I got to hurry. And then I went downtown and Port-au-Prince.
She thinks she has to hurry because I'm going to make her hurry. I'm not making you hurry.
You're not making me hurry?
No, ma'am. No, ma'am.
Oh, I'll keep going. Praise God. It's a wonderful story, and I want you to hear it.
And you can hurry it a little bit, but you...
Yeah, okay. I can hurry a little bit. I'm going to hurry a little bit. And so, folks, listen to Mom. I went downtown and told them, and they said to me, well, you know, you can't do anything about it. We're sorry, we can't help you. And I went outside and sat in the car and said again, if you ask anything in my name, I repeated the scripture again. And then I went to the orphanage, and I told the brother that drives for us, I said, listen, we're not going back to the orphanage. We're going to have victory today. And he said, Mama, what is victory? I said, victory is when you get what you want from God. And he said, you're going to get what you want from God today? I said, yes, today I'm going to get it. And so we went from place to place to trying to find someone who would drill a deep water well for me. Couldn't find anybody. The day was gone, about 5 p.m. And so he said, Mom, it's late, it's 5 p.m. I said, I know what time it is, honey. Keep going. I said, I'll tell you when to quit. And so then he began to get a little angry with me. And so then we were going along the street, and so he said, there's a man walking. Stop and ask him if he knows anybody who drills deep wells. And he said, no, Mama, that's a Haitian. And if he knew where deep well, anybody would drill a deep well, he would have one. I said, honey, go ask the man what I said. So he went to the man and asked him, and I saw the man point his hand. And I began to clap my hands and praise God for victory. So when he came back to the truck we were in, I said to him, turn right up that road, because I saw the man pointing that way. So we turned up that road and went about 5 minutes. And when we did, I saw a lady with a little cap on her head. I said, stop here. And when he stopped, I said, ma'am, do you speak English? She said, yes, I'm an American. And I just got so excited, I just had a fit almost. And I said, well, she said, what do you need, ma'am? I said, I need somebody who would drill a deep water well for us on my property where my kids are in school. She said, well, that's what my husband does. He drills deep water wells. I got out of the truck and had me a Pentecostal fit. And she said, I said, well, where are they? She said, they're not here. They're working. I said, well, when are they coming? She said, in about 4 hours. And I said, can I wait here for them? She said, yes, you can wait. And this brother who was driving for me said, Mama, it's 5:00. I said, honey, I don't care what time it is. We are waiting for these two men. And I said to her, I said, where are you from? She said, we're Mennonites from Pennsylvania. And so I had me another Pentecostal fit. And so I sat down and waited till those men came back from where they were working. When they came back, I told them what I needed. He said, lady, we'll do that for you. I said, how much will it cost? He said, $3,000. And I said, Jesus, I don't have $3,000. I said, Jesus, I know you know what to do. I said, just keep talking. And so while I was talking, the man said, lady, we're going to help you. We're going to do it for a lot less. We're going to help you because we see you need it. And we're going to be a blessing to you. And oh, it was so wonderful, folks. And the man said, I'm going to do it for you for $2,000. So the man, I gave him the $2,000, and I showed him where our place was, and he said, I'll be there this certain time. I'll be there for you to do your water for you. And so I went on to my place. At the time he promised, he showed up at my place, and because I gave him the $2,000. He showed up at my place, and he said, oh, lady, I'm ready to do the work for you. He said, where do you want your well dug? I said, in front of the church. He said, okay, wherever you say, we'll do it. He said, I gotta find out where your water is. He was gone 2 hours, and when he came back, he had my money in his hand. He said, lady, here's your money. I have sad news for you. You don't have a teaspoon of water on your property. We can't help you, and I'm very sorry. And here's your money. I refused to reach for the money. I turned and went in the orphanage and shut the screen door. He followed me to the door. He said, did you hear me, lady? He said, yes, I did, ma'am. He said, well, here's your money. I'm trying to give you back your money because you don't have water on this property at all. And I kept walking in the house. He said, please, we've got to leave, and I'm trying to give you your money. I said, sir, I don't want the money. I want water on this property. And if you can't give it to me, I know who can. He said, well, if you know who can, you go get them, because we're not the ones who can, because we can't do it for you. Pastor, I'm almost finished. He said, we can't do it for you, and so here's your money. I didn't take the money. I reminded God in the Word. He said, if you ask anything, St. John chapter 14, hallelujah. And I went to the Word again and began to read the Word again to Jesus. I read Him His own Word. If you ask anything in my name, I will do it. And I said it again and again and again. And folks, listen to Mama today. When the man was so amazed at me because I wouldn't take the money, he was just, he didn't know what to think of me. And so when he came back to the screen again, he said, we can't play. We're businessmen, and we can't do this. We've got to go. And I walked away from him again. So he went inside, and he said, all right, I'm going to dig. And if I dig one inch, you've lost $2,000. I didn't say one word to him. I wasn't talking to him. I was talking to God. And folks, let me tell you something. When I got through talking to God about His own Word, I went on about my business. I looked outside and the men were putting the machine together, what they're supposed to do, to drill. And the teeth went in the ground and began to turn. And when he did, he said, you just lost $2,000, lady, because we're drilling for the water that you said you would. But we're not going to get water. There's no water here. This, any of your neighbors could have told you there's no water here. And I didn't answer him. I just kept talking to God and thanking God for His Word that I read in the Bible. And then what happened was the men were going down in the ground. They had pipe. And each pipe was 20 feet. And when he went down in the ground with the pipe, I was praising God for His Word and what He promised. And he put a second pipe to it and tied it to it, and it went down in the ground. And when he did it the third time, all of a sudden, water came out of the ground. Isn't Jesus wonderful? And those two men had a pit. They didn't know what to do. One fell on a rock and sat there with his mouth wide open. And I was shouting and dancing and having me a good time and the water coming out of the ground. That's 4.5 years ago. Water is still coming out of the ground on my property because I believe the promises I found in God's Word. He said, if you ask anything in my name, pray. St. John chapter 14, praise God for Jesus.
Yes, hallelujah.
And you know what I'm so glad about? Every promise, He made wonderful promises in the Word. Wonderful promises in here. And the Bible says every promise. St. John chapter 14, verse 14 is another wonderful promise. And the Bible says, every
promise in the book is mine.
Every chapter, every verse, and every line. Oh, you know it. I am living in His love. Divine. Sit down.
Every promise in the book is mine.
Every chapter, every verse, every line. I am living in His love divine. Every promise in the book is mine.
I was home and I come to church.
Yep.
And was sitting in my seat. That's my seat.
Yes, ma'am.
Everybody knows that's my place.
Yes, ma'am.
Here at Home Life.
Yes.
And oh, I was sitting there and just waiting before the Lord. And He blew on me like this. The wind of the Lord is delicious.
Yeah.
He blew on me, and it was wonderful. I didn't know what else he was going to do, and I didn't do anything, and so he did nothing else. But I'm waiting for Jesus to come in more than a wind, but to fill us with his presence completely until we're never the same again, because we'll be just like Jesus. And isn't that wonderful? Isn't that wonderful? I want to be just like Jesus. I want to look just like him. Black and all, I want to look like him. He can be any color you want to be.
They don't care.
The miracle is I'm going to be just like Jesus. That's a miracle, praise God. And I love him with all my heart. And I'm so glad to be here tonight. I'm glad for each one of you. And we're going to give ourselves to Jesus and just see what Jesus does when we give him everything. Praise God. God bless you. Fight the devil and have to fight people.
Yes. The devil and people, right?
The devil and people.
Yeah.
And, but I win. Yeah. Here I am, I win. The devil is not, he's not in me, and he doesn't tell me what to do, so I come to church. The devil says you're too tired, and I say to myself, I sure am tired. Out loud, I say, where's my shoes? Where's my coat? Where's my sweater? And I keep on getting ready. And before you know it, I arrive right here. Because I belong here. And so this is where I end up coming, right here.
Amen.
I praise God for that. He's so wonderful.
Yes, he is.
He's so precious.
Yes, he is.
I'm so glad to be in service for the Lord.
Amen.
I owe it to him.
Amen.
I owe my life to Jesus.
Amen.
Everything I am, everything I've got, everything I'll ever get,
Amen,
belongs to Jesus.
Amen.
Keep praying for Mama.
Yes.
I love each one of you. You're so precious. Isn't this a beautiful church? Let's keep coming.
Good idea.
I see empty seats. Just keep coming. Because Jesus is here and he's coming in person. That's going to be marvelous tonight. That's going to be wonderful to see Jesus. I can't wait. I know it's going to happen. And I want to be here to see it done. But I'm going to be in it. I'm part of it. I'm not going any other way. I'm waiting for Jesus. God bless you. I love you.
Now, what we're going to do today, you know, Mama loves her dollar bills. And she informed me she was about out. And so, Mama has the church. We bought her this new outfit today that we wanted her to have. And we're going to give her all our dollars. So, if y'all will bring the buckets and you guys put one on each side of Mama, and then we can all put our dollars in those buckets because Mama's going to love this money. She really likes for us to put it in her lap, to tell you the truth. So bring your dollars, and y'all come up close to her so she can see that y'all, Mama, don't let them take your money. Get up here. Make them get up here so you can see it, Mama, okay? All right, everybody come bring your dollars. You want us to put it in your lap, Mama? Mama's gonna have more money than all of us. Yeah. Mama loves her dollars. Look at both these buckets. That's all yours. Look in here. It's yours.
Oh, this is so wonderful to have you do this. You've proven your love to me like words could never say. I love you with all my heart, and I want to keep on loving you and giving you back to Jesus. Praise God. God bless you.
Help me get close to her.
I am ready, ready. I am so glad my God belongs. Jesus belongs to me. Put your mic up.
I praise the Lord.
Amen, amen.
I praise the Lord.
Amen, amen. Sit down. Amen, amen. Amen, amen. Mic up.
You can't hear me?
No, hold it up here.
How's that?
That's better.
Well, how's this?
Do this one, it's lighter.
I praise the Lord.
Amen, amen.
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 That's why I praise the Lord.
Amen, amen.
I praise the Lord.
Amen, amen.
Oh, hallelujah. I'm so glad I belong to Jesus. I am so glad I belong to Jesus. I am so glad I belong to Jesus.
And Jesus belongs to me.
That's why I sing.
Amen, amen.
That's why I sing.
Amen.
That's why I sing.
Amen, 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 amen.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise God. Wonderful.
Happy birthday. Y'all
God
say it one more time
you.
Together.
God bless each one of
Happy
you.
Happy birthday, Eleanor. We love you.
Oh, marvelous. You're so precious. God bless you. Dark clouds of time hide my day. Disturb my faith. dies of time, hide my day. Sometimes I can't find my way. One thing I can truly say, nothing disturbs.
Bye.
Christ. You're so precious to me. And you're precious to Jesus. God bless you, children.
Come on in here, Mama. All right, church, stand up. Close on her. Get up real close. I'm telling you, this woman don't look like she's... Don't she look good? Yeah. She looks better than all of us. Amen. Mama, you look beautiful. Yeah. You look beautiful. Yeah. Mama, we're so glad you're at church.
Oh, I'm glad to be here.
Yeah. Hallelujah. We've been waiting on you.
Well, I'm so glad to be here.
We wanted you to come. We know you hadn't been feeling your best, but you're doing good now?
Yes, Jesus is here.
Yes, he is. You think Jesus is coming?
I know he's coming. I know he's on his way. And we're ready for his coming.
Yes.
Isn't that wonderful?
Yes.
Praise God for Jesus. Hallelujah.
Mama, what would you tell us about what does the church need to do to get ready for Jesus?
The church needs to stay ready for Jesus. Stay ready for Jesus. No fighting, no cussing, no arguing. No finding fault, no complaints. Just get ready for Jesus, because indeed he is coming.
Will you do one more thing for me?
Yes.
Will you pray for us?
Yes, I pray.
Okay, pray for all of us.
I want to pray. Close your eyes, shut out the world. Take in Jesus, precious Father God. In the name of Jesus, I come before you for the people of God, for the saints of God, for this beautiful mission. I come, Lord Jesus, presenting them to you, knowing their needs, knowing their wants, what their desires. Father God, I pray that you meet every need. That let every need be known to you. Let every heart be known to you. Let every precious soul be known to you today, tonight. Let us all bow before you. Let us all surrender all to you. Praise God for Jesus tonight. Praise him for his loving care and his tender mercies. Because he loves us with an everlasting love. We praise him because he first loved us and gave himself for us. He gave his life that we could live. And we're so glad we belong to him.
Amen.
We love him because he first loved us. And we're so glad for Jesus, aren't we?
Amen.
Praise God, we know him. We know him, we love him, and we know he loves us. Praise God. I just want to say I'm so glad to be here. I'm glad to see all the children and the teenagers and that they're in church on Sunday. It's wonderful to see the training they're receiving. Please, adults, I just want them to keep them in church and keep them in Sunday school. Keep them loving Jesus. It's not in vain. Your work is not in vain. The children's work is not in vain. So just keep doing it. Let's just keep doing it. Praise God. God bless you. I love you.